Take pictures as I walk up. This is big. It's a big moment for me. On what side, sir? Well, why would you let me go on this side? Jesus Christ. For the love of God. I'm here to take back what's mine. Right?
Why am I so aggressive? I'm sorry.
I'm a high roller. So it's only right that I win the high roller event.
I'm about to do the super high roller event and win. Tracy, what am I doing? I'm doing a super high roller event, right?
I'm here to play the super high roller tournament. I didn't want to get hurt before the tournament. That's why I ducked down. Right, watch yourself, duck down. Here, duck again. I duck down. You gotta duck down. Do I duck down? Okay, I'll duck down. Are you sure?
Yes.
What's up, son?
Oh, my name is Daniel. I got a poker patch.
What's up, buddy? How you
doing? How are you, man?
See you, man.
How are
you? Say?
Are you going right now?
I'm gonna go play, yeah.
What? So you guys are gonna, is this like your strategy?
I don't usually, no. I usually go like 4 hours late.
Yeah. Shake my hand now, people. Get it before it gets hot. Hello, my name is Kevin Hart, the winner of the Super High Roller Tournament. Hello. Good to meet you. Hello, my name is Kevin Hart, the winner of the Super High Roller Tournament.
But I'm ready to play.
You ready?
I'm hungry. I'm ready. Inspired.
I'm gonna go shower and come down right now.
Okay.
You think you got an edge on me? Is that what you think? You think you got a little edge on me?
A little bit. Just sounds
Dan,
good.
You smell great.
Aqua
what is
Gio.
That?
Aqua de Gio.
Aqua de Gio.
Gotta get some.
I thought it was loser. Yeah. This is the weirdest anymore.
Okay. You didn't
I'm sorry.
Man, huh?
I'm sorry. That was just out of conduct. I'm just trying to get in your head. I'm sorry about that.
All right?
I'm sorry about that. I'll see you in a second.
Okay.
Where's your fucking pants, man?
Sorry, I got
it. What are you doing? What are you doing? Poker players think they better than me. They not! Sir, I'm the winner. Excuse me. What seat is mine? How you guys doing?
Good morning, sir.
Daniel, good morning to you. It's about time I got one of these. It's about time you guys realize what I'm capable of around here, Daniel. I am the Kevin Hart. Let's just address two things. One, the obvious fear on a lot of these players' faces, you know. It's still the beginning stages. So I normally come in and I like to get the first little piece of nerves out the way. So for those who do not know, I am the Kevin Hart. The is now part of my name. It's how I introduce myself, but they still think I don't give a shit. It's all mind games. I love doing this, like saying the most ridiculous. I'm in everybody's head right now. 9 times out of 10, I'm gonna dump that first buy-in off. You know, it's just to send out a message that I don't give a shit. I'm about to bring cool to the game. And after I send that message out, then that's when I come back and actually give a shit. So it doesn't look like I'm one of the stupid people that I'm talking about. Damn it, Kevin. I didn't. I couldn't feel my, these are light. So I couldn't feel them on my actual face. That's why I said that. As if you can't see through the glasses. Like, and you know, a lot of these guys wear glasses. People that wear glasses are stupid. Wait a minute. Shit. I forgot I had my glasses on. We got to edit that. Edit that. Tracy, get a reporter. Tracy, I need a reporter to come over here and get this quote. Kevin Hart is making poker cool. Poker is now taking a step in a sexy direction. Shit. Damn it. Because of him, end quote. But it's gotta come from you. I'm Kevin Hart, AKA Mr. Whoopass. If I didn't have these glasses on, you would've saw me wink.
Let's see if I get lucky.
Is that a straddle?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Who, is Daniels?
Yes, sir.
He's not gonna raise his, so I call.
I didn't commit to anything.
What is it?
485.
You know what? I'm gonna come out and say it. I'm sick of her. I called.
Kevin's right, and he doesn't even know it.
That's bullshit. That's some more Kevin's bullshit. Yeah, Kevin's bullshit. I don't want you to leave. So, because it's you, anybody else, I don't do this. Anybody else, I'll tell them to kiss my.
Oh.
I'm gonna give you. Here, let's give you 15K. Remember, and remember that comes from me.
When I get money, you will get it back, okay?
When you get money, you'll get it back. No, I'm giving it back to you so I can take it one more time.
Okay, so let's have some fun, right?
Daniel had nothing to do with this.
Okay. You borrow me?
There's no borrow. I'm just giving it to you. I'm giving it to you.
Okay, so.
No!
Let's go.
Oh, shit!
Now you scared.
All right.
We're gonna play No Limit Texas Hold'em. You got 100,000 in chips each.
I like it.
So I think we're ready, yeah? Shuffle up and deal. Coin flip.
Come in.
That's it.
Whoa! Shut up, that's so late.
Oh,
you guys are so late.
One,
I'm
one and 2,000 still?
I'm 2.
You're 2.
All right.
What's he gonna do?
So you saying
I don't think I show my coat in my hands right now.
Kevin Hart doubles
okay,
up.
Okay, you do it by yourself. It's good.
You're gonna
punish him. Punish him.
10,000
him. Punish
yeah, that's
him. Punish him.
Oh,
that's
shit.
In poker, we call that a tell.
Oh, right? Shit.
That's not a poker face.
Oh, shit.
That would be the opposite of a poker face.
They getting paid. Oh, shit.
Right. Punish him. Ooh.
All right.
He so never has anything when he does this sort of stuff. It's so funny.
All right.
I was ready to go
A-side,
over at the
chart.
A-side?
We're so close.
She was on to your shit, too. She was on to you. You were totally
I was ready.
On.
I was ready.
You
were
like,
Oh, shit. What? Oh, shit.
I'ma call these minis challenging.
Okay. We got a double challenge here.
Oh, yeah.
And a double challenge pop. Here we go. River
Anna
is?
Anna Hearts.
All right, so you lost.
I like it.
Here we go.
Balls, come on.
Lewis Hamilton.
Oh, no. Lewis so, Hamilton.
After your last race.
Right? First challenge essentially allows Kevin to send a message to anyone in your phone.
Ooh.
Okay? Yeah. Any message that you like. Hand that phone over. Unlock it.
I've been honestly doing some thinking about us, about us and our possibilities. Please text back ASAP. Let's put the tongue. If you're interested in the rest of my thoughts.
Oh.
Tongue eggplant.
And then let's do the devil face.
And the devil face. And it's been set.
All right. Eggplant. Peach. Eggplant. Cherries, as in the balls. Chili pepper. Then corn on the cob, corn on the cob. Followed by eggplant. Peach. Balls again.
What?
Tell me your text reads. After your last race, I've been honestly doing some thinking about us and our possibilities. If you're interested in the rest of my thoughts, please text back ASAP. P.S. You race fast and I run fast. Sounds like a perfect match for me. Tongue, devil.
Jesus.
Okay.
Have a good one.
Oh, wow.
So we've officially got one challenge now. Now to go out with a little fit.
That's a great challenge.
Oh, okay. No. Put this
That's
on.
That's my shirt. That's my real shirt. That's my real shirt.
It looks good on you.
I'm going to stretch my shirt out, man.
All right. Wow.
That's a large.
Put that on, you get yourself back in the game.
That's a large.
Yeah. I'm so cute. Okay.
Yo, don't stretch my shirt out. Don't stretch my shirt out, man.
There you go.
You're a married man.
I know, off the market.
Calm down, ladies. It's all gone, ladies. You missed a chance.
You missed your chance. You had a chance. You chose 50 Cent. You chose wrong. She chose wrong back then.
Stop. Why is he trying to steal? Look at him. You see that? That might have been the most blunt act of racism I've ever seen in my life. Like, what? As I'm talking about what he doesn't like, he just gets up and turns his back.
So I propose, man, and I can honestly say, will you stop laughing? No, I was serious when I said that. That wasn't a joke. I was serious. I'm happy, though. She deserves it because I can't keep just letting this walk around free. That's not fair to her. Like, I gotta lock this up. I'm talking about my body. That's what I'm talking about. So.
Well, let me ask you a question.
Ask me. I'm listening.
I was looking at your Instagram.
Stay! Go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead. No. Let's all just take the time to understand that. I'm a big deal. But oh, thank you.
You are. He has remained the same. You have remained the same. You're a very normal person. You have the same people around you, and I will say that for you.
You better say it because it's the truth.
Yeah. Well, I just fucking said it. I mean, how many more times do you want me to say it? Would she?
First of all,
she doesn't want to do it. She shouldn't have to.
She
do it.
She definitely would. That's the first thing. I mean,
I don't think that. I don't think she would.
I didn't kiss Halle Berry in my movie because I didn't want to mess up Halle Berry's life. Okay, that's what you need to understand. If your thoughts are, oh my God, Kevin lips smelt like roses and cinnamon, then that's bad.
Is that what you think your lips smell like, roses and cinnamon?
100%.
Who told you that?
They smell like roses and cinnamon and cucumber watermelon. You don't kiss these lips and go back to regular lips. These are some amazing kissing lips. So I said, I'm not going to do that to you, Holly. I said, I think it's best that we don't cross that line, because when you leave here today, you should be thinking of good thoughts. I've known her. I've known her for quite some time.
How? Where did you meet her?
What do you mean, where did you meet her? You meet people around. You go to these parties, you bump into people, you go, oh my God, I love you. I'm a big fan. Then they go, who are you? And I'm like, I'm Kevin Hart. This is when I was nobody. Hey, stop it. That's when it hit that I was really a sex symbol. Because I was like, this is obviously about sex. She's trying to get to me. And I told her.
She obviously wants your baby.
No, and I was like, yo, you know I'm engaged. I let it out the way, because at the time I was engaged. And I was like, I regret that I didn't kiss her. I do a little bit, because I was like, that was my moment. I should have did it there. Because I was hard the whole time. And this is...
And throw food at me, which is never good. You know? It's never good. And I said, who threw it? You know, you expect to be quiet so you can say some stuff to just look like you're about to defend yourself. And he was like, I did. And I said, well, shit. Brother, this was at a different time in my life. Sweet Cheeks was a male strip club, and I wasn't dancing.
Right, you're doing the audience work.
Yeah, you know, I would basically, okay, let me explain it. Mm-hmm. So the strippers, and I was on stage one time, and this lady was like, pull your dick out. And I was like, wait a minute, man. I ain't even about that. I'm up here slanging these jokes. I'm here for the joke life, you know? But they didn't want to hear that. Why they changing?
You gotta keep the show going.
We got some comedy. And it wasn't really a good segue.
It doesn't seem like it would be.
It would go from the male strippers, and they would go introducing Lil Kev the Bastard. That was my name at the time. But there's some shit going on, man. You know, I don't know how this is gonna come out. I'm about to fucking shit fire. That's what's about to happen, man. This shit is hot. Ooh, we out here,
get
boy.
There.
Hey, my lips tingling. Hey, my fucking lips. My lips feel like they bleeding. I don't know what's going on, man.
Here, you'd never put this on a sandwich. It's for psychos. It's for people who burned out.
I see why I called the bomb, because that bitch just blew up. What we say? Oh, shit. You say what?
So I want to give you a few between a rock and a hard place scenarios, and you tell me how you'd look at it as glass half full. Sound good?
Yeah.
Getting booed off stage.
Okay.
Getting booed off stage.
Whoo! Give me a water, man! See me over here struggling? Shit! Huh? That's how like a black dude made this shit.
So, there always seems to be two approaches to fashion and comedy, right? You can either dress like you.
I said, what you say, man? This shit making me delirious.
That's what it does.
I feel like I done did a drug, man.
That's what it does. It gets kind of trippy.
Yeah, I'm high. Shit. All right. Hold on, bro. Yo, I'm hot as shit. he sitting here like ain't shit going on. I'm over here breaking down, brother. I'm breaking down, man. I'm fucking. Yeah, I feel like a goddamn cokehead out this bitch. My nose is shit running. I'm sniffling the shit. Hold on, man. You go first.
Me go first?
You go first, but I'm a guess.
Okay.
Shit. Why you got to make eye contact?
I love to tell you, yes, it actually came from an Irish forefather that did this. That's not the case. His mother was reading the paper and she was eating some cereal. And somebody in the back said, oh, Shay. She said, that'd be a good name. And that's it. That's how it happened. Right, let me educate you something. Black people are notorious for picking things that they saw one day and say, that's my baby name. That's all that was. That's all that was, Grandma. Yeah.
Are you really there?
Yeah.
Roy's Rolls can't be that big.
First of all, it looks like I grew up there.
That's called my highlighter running outfit.
So, yeah, right there. You see that?
You wear that.
Yes. Yes.
That's incredible.
Yes, that looks very good, man.
That's a terrific idea. I am the opposite.
I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm dark skinned. So when I run at nighttime, I'm afraid because I don't want to get hit by a car. So what I do is I find bright colors from the gym.
You're friends with a lot of athletes.
I am.
Well, you're hanging out with Shaquille O'Neal.
I know them all, man. You go down the list. You know, these guys like to be around me because of my my physical attributes. It's motivation. Because, you know, first of all, I'm a dad first. You understand? Respect me as a father. So when I'm disciplining my kids and I'm yelling, when I'm done, don't turn around and grab me and shake me and pat me on the back. Our relationship took a turn for the worse not too long back because Shaq has a habit of picking me up in front of my kids, and I don't like it. I don't like it.
He picks you up?
Yeah, I don't like it. I don't like it one bit because you're taking away what I just did. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's very hard for me to go back and say sit down to my kids when Shaq is telling me to do the same thing. I don't like it. And I stopped talking to him for a while. Yeah, we played twins. But here's the funny thing when he pitches it. He says, now listen, I'm going to be the Arnold Schwarzenegger and you're going to be the Danny DeVito. As if it could have been the opposite way. What other way could it have been, Shaq,
to this stuff? Make that movie.
No, come on.
I'll produce it.
Yeah, just give me like. You will to laugh and see me get picked up every damn day. You don't fool me, Colin. You don't fool me. What I feel like the three of us should collab, and I got the perfect role because.
You didn't have time to say collaborate.
No, collab.
No time for that.
Man, I'm too cool.
You didn't have time for socks
I'm
and no time for the
cool
or rings.
For
yeah.
full words. Okay. I don't go full words.
Got it.
Like you get so much attention, and all I'm doing, I'm picturing being in the scene, serious scene. Something's about to go down, and the only way I get distracted is because you walk by, and I'm like, something just went bad. You could be streetwalker number one. Streetwalker number one. Listen, not number two. Streetwalker. We kept saying the way you walk. Like,
shit.
No. It's not you in real life.
I want to be in the car with you guys. I have a gun, equal status.
That's and you're mad because we didn't pay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm streetwalker. I'm not a male prostitute.
I'm not saying you are, but in the movie, you could be. In the movie.
No,
it's a movie. And now I'm mad. Then you pull out your guns.
I get guns at the end?
But they're not loaded because you've never had to use them because you're a good streetwalker.
That's the plot line? I'm a male prostitute. I take care of you guys and you didn't pay me? What kind of movie is that?
You can't keep a straight face.
I can't even keep a straight face. Y'all don't know how much we mess with him the way he walks. We're like, Carter, man, you gotta.
There's nothing wrong with the way I walk.
Oh God.
That's the way I walk.
Oh God.
I have a condition.
White people always gotta go first and last. You always gotta do them both.
Ice Cube.
Now call him Cube.
You know, from now on, I call him Cube.
And then call me Lil' Kev.
I want a sandwich, but can you guys give me the Asiago bun? And I'll never forget how complicated his order was at Wendy's. And me and Cube really looked. It was like, this might be the whitest shit I've ever seen. Listen, okay, there's a scene. Uh-huh. We can do a scene where I come in and I got to talk to white guy number one.
Uh-huh.
You know, I say something like, hey, did you see where that guy went? And you're like, that way. Cut! You're done. That's it.
That's it?
That's all
I want to be some. I want to be street.
Why not? White guy number one can be street.
You can't even say that without laughing.
No, okay. White guy number one can be street.
You have done just so amazingly well in stand-up.
You damn right I have.
Yes.
You damn right I have. Yes. So throughout my show, I have a bunch of pointless fire. Like, it has...
The best fire is pointless fire.
No, literally, it has nothing to do with my show. Like, after a joke, people laugh, and I go, get fire. And it just explosions. I want to take a second to give a shout-out to my co-star, Regina Hall, because
Regina Hall.
No, Regina Hall, very, very funny female, man.
Funny, beautiful, funny. Who doesn't like Regina Hall?
You know, like you said, it's a remake of the original movie about last night, but this is my first sex scene, people, and, you know, it's what the people wanted. It is. People were curious, and they're going to get what they've been asking for. You know what? And Regina, you know, this was tough for her because she, you know, she couldn't get through a lot of these takes because for her, it was real. You know, like, I'm acting.
You're just doing,
like,
the professional.
I'm doing what I'm supposed to do as an actor. you know, guys, you're going to see a piece of my butt. It's not, I didn't go full butt. It's just the top part of my butt crack. It's confusing because it looks like it could be a roach or my butt crack. But it's something. It's definitely something. She's like, oh, I don't want to cut. And I'm like, you have to. It's the nature of the business, you know. But I don't blame her. I definitely don't blame her. I see why she was doing what she was doing. It's something.
Thank you for clearing that up.
Yeah, I don't want you
guys. You don't want that getting out there.
Ew, Kev's got a roach in his butt. No, it's not. That's
bad
my butt.
Hygiene on that. Yeah.
That's right, ladies. I'm gonna take this little piece of chocolate and freeze it up. That's right. Off the market, ladies. Off the market.
I can't even enjoy that.
You don't.
This is the number one. You don't go over, honey. Well, I'll just check out until the wedding. Yeah.
You don't think that's gonna work?
You're screwed. No. No budget.
I just don't want to.
There's no budget.
I don't understand. All right. I've.
No,
I've
no, no. You're talking to. We. Yeah. We're not married understand. Together anymore, but.
21 years I've been married.
We're each married.
We've been
married
for 21 years.
21 years, yeah.
Holy shnikey diddles.
Yeah.
21 years. Wow.
And if I step out of it
It's just you. It's your thing. Yeah. I want you to have the best day ever, babe. But I don't want to. I don't want to be a part of that. I don't want to. I don't want. I don't want that. I don't want. I just don't want that.
That is wise.
There's gonna be like, I need help with these decisions.
And
you're just gonna say no.
Yeah.
All right. Well.
To her face.
Yeah.
Good luck with
that. To her face. Yeah. Baby, can you help me?
Nope.
Just like that. Nope. Got a big dopamine pinch. So I just make the wedding planner really uncomfortable to be around me. Just sitting in some underwear with holes in them on the couch, playing with my belly button. That's him? That's the guy you're marrying? Yeah. Amazing guy. I can say in the top two most amazing people that I've ever had the opportunity to work with. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much.
Well, no.
Yeah, I got what you were saying. Top two. Nice, I'll take it.
You took it.
I took it.
You just took it.
I not only took it, I made it up. he's
grounded,
great.
Man, just down to earth. The first black bear, I'm not talking about a newer black, the first one, and it's like taped up, and he's like, yeah, he's like, they'll never get me. I was like, who? Who are you afraid of, Will?
That's the one that has a little crank on it.
No, nothing.
Right.
I'm the only dumbass that spends all his money on clothes. I'm going to be broke. I already know it. Y'all going to look up. I ain't going to have no money. Where is it? Right here. This is where it went. Right here. Every dime. Right here. Because for some reason, when you put on something expensive, you step outside, you expect people to go, that's expensive. Like, they don't. They don't.
They don't know.
Never gotten one of them. Not one. Nobody has ever done it. I said, you know what I'm gonna do at the end of my show? I'm gonna turn around, show the back of my jacket, and put up a peace sign. The crowd gonna go off. I did it. Nobody said nothing. Absolute silence.
It was a pro-war crowd. Sometimes getting no laugh is much funnier than getting the laugh.
Oh, for you, because you understand. But you know.
What do you mean for me? What the hell's that?
No, not like that.
It's a crowd that likes war.
Person was like, what's that on his back? I was like, that's what I'm doing. So I did the peace sign to try to show y'all.
I think it's about peace. School crossing.
It was never, nothing.
We have a photo here. This man is stopping you.
Yeah.
This man is stopping you from getting up there.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about this exchange. What's happening here? The Super Bowl, you're at the Super Bowl. Eagles win. This is a giant night for the Eagles.
Yeah.
Giant night for you. You're a big fan. You tried to get up on stage during the trophy presentation. Yeah. He did his job.
Thank God.
Good. Yeah.
Thank God he did his job that day, because I was a little thing called intoxicated.
Yeah.
Now, you know, because of, first of all, you know, it was done correctly. All right. I don't get that many days. We win, and something in my head said, I need to go down there with the team. I'm moving gates out the way. Watch out. Sir, you can't move that. I'm Kevin Hart. it's going way too good. We took everybody out the suite. We have no passes. We have no, there's nothing to get us by the people that we're getting by. I'm literally walking by people, and they're like, excuse me, sir, I'm Kevin Hart. I'm going down. Middle of the Eagles huddle, they're pushing me around. It's great. I noticed because I watched the video later. They say.
Which is how you know you were at
this. This is how I know. I called you to come with me. I don't know. I got to get your new email address. That's what it is. I said that.
You called me on my email address?
Yeah. I called her. You don't answer your Hotmail line. I called you. Dude, huge Justin Timberlake fan, man. Thanks, man. Justin Timberlake, guys, one more time. Come on. Huge fan. Yeah. Now that I'm gonna, you got the money? You gave it to me?
But
I'm serious. I saw him at like Home Depot 2 weeks ago. He was helping people. Like, he wasn't even shopping. He was just helping people put stuff in the car.
I'm Shaq. I don't have nothing to do. You want me to grab it? I'll help you.
Behind in the back. What is Shaq doing? Since his retirement, he has nothing to do. He's in the most random places.
Thank you.
No, just
thank you very much. Hey. Shaq, good to see you. That's right.
really want to understand. Like, I'm 6'1". I'm not short.
No, I'm just small. Like, look, here's the bad part with me. Like, if I sit all the way back, look.
That's right. Now, what happened to your shoulder? You hurt your shoulder. What happened?
Dude, I hurt my shoulder. Thanks for picking me up. I could have died just now. You don't even know what happened to me. No. It's very serious, people. I suffered a very serious injury this weekend. I'm a daredevil. You know that, okay? Yeah. I'm a thug, Jay. My background speaks for itself. I've been to jail. Listen, what I'm saying... So we get off of the tube. I'm like, yeah, I want to do it. So he's got me and my brother. We both get on separate now. I was scared at first, but then in my mind, I start thinking like, oh, I'm gonna stick it. Like, I'm gonna come down and people are watching. They're gonna be like, oh, this is probably what Kevin Hart does on the side. So I was okay. I don't know I'm hurt at the time. I hear everybody on the boat. They're like, oh my God, Kevin. It sounded just like that. They're like.
How did it go again?
It was like, oh my God, Kevin.
Okay, thanks. These are all white people on the boat.
No. So once I saw I couldn't get it up, this is when I started to panic a little bit. I didn't cry, but you probably would have thought that that's what it was. Because it was. So, at this point in time, I'm flagging a guy because I want help. I'm like, remember? And you was like, you were fine. Someone was like, Shaq, you jammed your toe. You was like, argh. It was the same thing, so I saw it, I panicked, I lied to you not, I passed out, like, because I saw my shoulder out the socket. He was like, you're gonna be all right, and I was like, too late, I'm going. And it was over, I woke up in the hospital, it was popped back in. I'm at a different point in my life, I'm not lying anymore. I think that was my biggest problem when I was married, I was a liar.
Like, liar?
Yes, dude, I used to lie all the time, for no reason, just because I could. Like, I'm serious, like, stupid stuff. Kevin, what time is it, 6 o'clock? No, it's not. I don't care. I thought it was. Like, dude, you can't feed pigeons and tell a black woman that you fed pigeons. She's not gonna believe you. Like, what you doing? I'm feeding pigeons. No, you're not. I am. Listen. She's like, no. That's a girl. You tell that bitch. Stop making pigeon noises. You know what? My family, man, is the best. I got a great support group. My brother make me laugh, though. My brother, I call him King Negative. Mm-hmm. No matter how great something is, my brother finds a negative in it. Mm-hmm. I've never seen anything like it. Like, I just bought land. And I'm like, yo, man, instead of going out looking for a house, I bought land. I'm just going to build a house. He was like, good luck. You got no experience. I'm not physically building a house. That's his thing. In his mind, he's real. I don't care what it is.
Right.
It's the most negative thing I've ever seen in my life. Like, I've called my brother. Hey, Ken, yo, number one in the box office. Yeah, domestic. You didn't get released. What are you talking about? Like, dude, let me enjoy this. I'm just giving it to you real. What is your problem? It's just nonstop. I'm like, I love you to death, but it never fails. I don't care what it is. So when I see things, it makes me laugh. One guy called me. He's like, ugh, never seen anything more annoying than Kevin Hart and that little voice. It's just like a little Muppet with a battery. And I was like, that's pretty good. You know what I do, though? I love actually reading the worst stuff about me.
You do?
I swear, it's the fun. It makes me laugh. Like, first of all, I got thick skin. I'm a comedian. So I've talked about people. I've been talked about. That's the nature of my craft, of my business. So I was like, you're the best, and I sign it, and they give him a big bottle of wine.
That must confuse the hell out of them.
Yeah, it makes them, what is he saying? But they drank the wine.
I know they drank it.
It's the best.
You're a huge name, probably the biggest name in comedy right now,
Thank you, man.
Can have a private island to hang out on, but everybody has to start somewhere, and when you started out, it was rough. It was tough. It was tough going in the beginning.
For me, in the beginning, heck yeah, it was tough. I remember one time, I was doing a show, right? There was only 15 people there. But every time I went to go tell my punchline, somebody threw a strike. Dead serious. Like, it's a live bowling alley.
They're bowling while
they're
you're
bowling.
Telling
Listen,
jokes?
I'm in the middle lane. There's people bowling down here, people bowling down here. You know, I'm talking about a comedian, man. I used to do spots for food, you know, doing stand-up comedy. So when you go tough, you're talking about a guy who used to perform live shows in a bowling alley. And I'm like, man, listen, I don't know about y'all. Bang!
Yeah.
Man, listen, I don't know about y'all. I never told one joke. I just kept starting over and over again. You can go out, do what you want to do. I'm going to support you. After that, if you don't find a way to feed yourself,
Then you gotta go back to school, you gotta do something productive. I said, Mom, okay, give me a year doing this comedy. When I needed an apartment and I went and got one on my own, I couldn't afford to rent because I was trying to do comedy. So my mom, she was very religious. She said, look, Kevin, I'm gonna put you on my back. I got you for a year. Mom, you didn't give me rent this month. She's like, well, did you read your Bible? I'm like, Mom, look, I don't have time to talk about the Bible and stuff right now. I need the money. Like, this is for real. They're gonna kick me out. She's like, read your Bible, then talk to me. Mom, okay, goodbye. I hang up with my mom. Did you read your Bible? Mom, I don't want to read the Bible right now. I'm not gonna have a place to read it in a minute if you don't give me the money.
Right.
She's like, look, I'm not gonna do this with you, Kevin. Read your Bible, talk to me. It gets close to the third month. I'm like, oh my God, like they're really threatening to kick me out. I finally open up my Bible. When I open it up, my mom put all of the checks for the rest of the year in the Bible.
Amazing.
So I open it and all of my rent checks fall out and I just sat there with the dumbest look on my face. I ain't gonna do this. Another month go by, I'm getting eviction notices. Mom, stop playing. Like, if you don't give me this money, I'm gonna be homeless. Call my mom. I said, Mom, I see what you did. You put it in the Bible. She said, did you read it? No, but I got the checks.
What just happened?
What do you, don't.
What?
Don't you laugh like that.
You look like a detective that's a DJ.
I'm trying. This is why I need therapy. That's me. That's me in high school.
Whoa.
But yes. Don't laugh like that. Don't.
Whoa.
That's okay. Well, there's my picture.
Whoa.
No, cat. Yeah.
I hate that I'm standing right next to the stove. That's what I hate. Right? Like, there's no way for me to say I was a big child or nothing. Like, everything is right here.
It's the perspective.
No,
right,
it's really
there.
Bad. This is really bad.
I thought we were going to have some pretty good chemistry, but then it really exploded into a really cool bond and brotherhood. There is a mutual admiration. Kevin has a lot of drive and ambition. You know, his mouth is like the Energizer bunny, but that's okay. I do that because I'm very
like
smart.
First.
Yeah, you go first.
You see what I'm saying? You see what he did there, don't you? I'm not going to go first again.
Okay.
I bet you that. I'm not going first again while I'm sitting here.
I'm just saying, I have a lot of love and a lot of respect for you.
Mine's, I gave all, I was very positive the whole way through.
No, I know, but.
Yeah, but I didn't throw any shots.
That wasn't a shot.
But you waited for me to finish.
Energizer Bunny is actually a good thing.
Like, that's why I don't like to go first.
You see, it actually, you see it on screen when we get together.
Yeah.
And
and also, I do a lot of the heavy lifting.
Okay.
That's
all right.
That's a,
all right. Jumanji, welcome to the jungle, isn't there?
What up? When people see you on the street, I know they know who you are, but there's some people who don't know say, when are you going to fight Manny Pacquiao?
Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather. A little bit. I can't fight like him, though. My only two fights were with family, though. My cousin Kimberly, she beat me bad. Kimberly beat me bad. Kimberly was a bad one. I never should have went in there. I wish I had his money, though. I wish
Have you ever gotten in a fight?
Oh, man, yeah, I've lost a couple, George, honestly. You know, I have no problem with being honest. People, my record isn't that good on the streets. I was by myself. My cousin Kimberly grabbed my arm, slung me all over the floor. You know, the worst part about losing a fight is when you lose your shoe. Because then you gotta go find your shoe. That's the worst part. I don't like that part at all. My family hyped me up to do it. They was like, Kev, don't let her talk to you like that. You need to go hit her. And I was like, but you think, like, she's bigger. They was like, don't matter, man. Hit her. And I was like, well, if I miss, are y'all going to help me? They was like, yeah, go. I went downstairs. I didn't see nobody behind me.
All right, you were at probably one of the funniest things I've ever seen.
Okay.
And people that know, I want to ask you, everybody take a look at this video, and we're going to ask you to kind of narrate what was happening.
Puff had a party. He's called me, said, Kev, can you host a party with me? I said, yeah, dude, I said, I'll do it. I said, I'm in New York. So he said, look, we're creating this little sexy scene in the bathroom. It's gonna be girls in the tub, you, Trey Songz, Fabulous. I'm up there and I'm hosting, you know? I'm promoting the party. I'm like, yeah, man, this is a nice event. You see, we up here in the tub. I hear Trey Songz behind me, like, it's nice. It's gonna look like it's the place to be. We're gonna Ustream it. I said, oh, that's gonna be hot. So we get up there, I'm hosting, you know? First of all, I'm a sex symbol, okay? First of all, if somebody's hair is on fire, it's a panic. Like, you know, it's a yell, yo, your hair. It should be crazy. You would have thought Trey was singing. This is all I heard. I heard, yo, your hair's on fire. Because, like, literally,
like the flame, like George, the flame grew. Like it was like somebody threw gasoline on it. Like so. It was like an album, like it was one of his tracks. Like, yo, your head's on fire. I turned around, I saw it, I was like, oh! At the end of the day, I don't want to die, you know? Oh, I don't know if you guys know, weaves are the most flammable thing out. A weave, if there had been another girl next to it with a weave, that thing would have caught faster than the forest fire. So when I saw it, I was like, ow, ow! So my first instinct was to save myself. Because, you know, at the end of the day, it's true. I just said, let me save myself. Now, to camera, I run. I'm like, did you get that on tape? Only reason why I said that is because I didn't really get to see the whole thing. So I wanted to see it all.
What can you pass along to your kids that they would understand?
You know what, George? It's funny you say that because I've been having a hard time with figuring out the type of life lessons, you know, that I'm trying to hand my kids. You know, basically, as a father, you want to teach your kids certain things.
I think it's safe to say you were probably raised very, very tough,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Tough
from
family.
Yeah,
from the street. Do you...
My main thing is teaching my son how to fight.
And now, how old is he?
My son's 3, okay? Now, look, you don't see what goes on in these daycares, all right? These little kids are crazy. Here's the one thing, like, okay, my daughter, and this is me being very honest, you guys, my daughter's a little princess, beautiful, she's spoiled. So, you know, I'm one way with her, but with my son, I'm like, I live in L.A., I'm in the valley, you know, my son ain't around tough kids, all right? I caught a little boy putting paste in my son's mouth, that's when I had enough. I said, I'm gonna teach my son how to defend himself. Now, the only problem I'm having, my son thinks he's Spider-Man, George, for real. Like, listen. I'm not joking. So I go to pick him up from school, right? This little boy is hitting my son in the head with a truck, right? My son on the floor doing this. like when we play, he wet me. He like listen. But because I'm dad, like because I'm his dad, when he does it, I gotta act like I'm caught. I'm like, oh no, you know, let me out. I yelled, I got so mad, I said, boy, you're not, get your ass up. You're not Spider-Man, man. You're not Spider-Man. He tried to get me while I was talking, but I had to play. I was like, okay, let me out, let dad out. Y'all laughing, I'm being so serious, man. My household, my son is in trouble if I don't save him. He really thinks he's Spider-Man, George.
Don't judge
my son, okay? I had my son come here and web this whole audience right now. My son will web all y'all. And y'all better act like y'all caught in the net. I'm from Philadelphia, you guys. You know, city where it go down at. I don't know. All right, so listen. So I don't know what that was. I saw it in the video. I'm from a school of A's, B's, and C's. You know, D's are bad, F's are bad. So in my mind, I'm like, you got worse than an F? Like, you got an E? Like, you're 5. I said, like, how dumb is my baby to get an E? That, I almost punched my daughter in the forehead. But I had to stop. No, I'm serious. Only reason why I didn't do it, because my son was like, and he stopped me. So I couldn't. I was ready to punch. My son stopped me.
Oh, my God.
She was like, no. Like, her mom told me it was excellent and good. But that just made me even more angry, because I'm like, who gave y'all the audacity in California to change these things? Okay? No. For years, it was A's, B's, and C's. E's and G's? Don't nobody do that. Like, you got little cars that I can promote. You know, give me something that I can get out of cool. I'm jumping out this daggone truck. I'm serious, George. I fell twice in the commercial. I fell 2 times.
That's your subject. For the next party, man, in case it gets out of control, I blinged out.
Go. Pick up 2 of my friends. You cool with that?
Okay.
Hey!
Yeah. Hey! You know you got it, right?
Yeah.
You all right?
Yeah, okay, rule number one. Don't f*** this up.
Next. Hey, man.
Fucking
hey, up. Hey. Tupac was one of the biggest thugs I know.
and he always wore his seatbelt.
That's a good point. That's a real good point.
All right, here we go.
Slow down! Jesus, why'd she take off all crazy?
You're the funny friend zone guy.
No, I'm not. Women don't put me in a friend zone. When they see me, first thing that come to mind is I want to bump bellies with
only
them.
When you score a touchdown.
I done been in the end zone lots of times, and let me tell you something, when I get in there, I dance. What do you mean? Driving a car without power windows is a big mistake. I can't do this all day. And do you know how stupid this looks? And you go, mother look how stupid I look.
How y'all doing? How you doing there? You good?
We looking for marijuana.
Yeah, we're gonna buy weed. Have you done crack?
No.
Okay. Booger sugar.
Booger sugar?
You in here doing coke through your butt? They say it getting in Russia. I just want to know
Kevin
how that conversation goes.
Keep going. What's your favorite fast food?
Popeyes.
Popeyes? Oh! Diana, I almost married you just now.
That's an insane amount of smoke.
What are you talking about?
This is like a Cheech and Chong movie up front. You gotta crack your window, we're gonna die. We're going to die. We're going to jail.
You blocking a crosswalk right now?
Sir, here's a good thing about me. First and foremost, I'm a Christian. And what I learned is that Jesus once walked on water. I don't know where I'm going with this, guys. I really can't.
What do you guys think? You are ready for your driver's test. Isn't she ready now, guys?
No, you are. Listen, and if the instructor says anything that you don't like, you throw a battery at his ass. This chicken?
Crack. Crack cocaine right here.
I wonder if you could take this up.
The butt?
The butt.
I would do it. That's the only time I would do it.
Diana, you...
Hey, man.
Look, hold I'm on. Not saying that I'm scared, because I'm not, but this ain't safe. We've been on the phone for some time right now, and it looks like we're selling ass.
I mean, you...
I know that's the look that you guys
are that ain't the look
world.
I want to put out to the world.
Hey, cool white boy. Yeah, no. His jeans be tight, though.
His jeans do be tight.
His jeans is tight.
I mean, damn.
Look like Conan's back pocket's touching right now. I ain't never seen nothing like it in my life. Are any of you girls single?
I am.
Anthony, this is when you ask for the number.
This is amazing.
This is Anthony. Anthony, put huge penis next to me. Yeah, that's how she gonna know it's you.
Show her your
grab the stuff. We you, man. He's on my ass. He's on my ass. We straight him, man. I gotta go back. I left my brown bag. I ain't got no socks on.
Right. That. You got no socks.
I got no socks on, man.
Think how much they'd be cheering if you had socks.
No. His top lip is always straight. That's all day. That's his lip, all day. Q, you wanna eat?
Maybe.
Like, all right, I guess. You know what Q does that annoys me though? He makes noises every time he sits down or gets up.
Really? Like what? Like,
it makes me so mad. I don't know. Like, you know how people do stuff that gets under your skin a little bit? You know, when I'm sitting there messing with you about your walk, I do things like that to him all day.
Right.
All day, man.
Right.
But not, he don't walk like you. But it's not, I'm saying, if he did, I would give it to him the same.
Right.
He's a rocker. When it's time to get up, he's like,
He's not 80 years old.
Yeah,
it's hilarious.
The ready, set, go, get up. Ready, set, go.